Welcome to another Teardown video. Remember this? From when you were like a kid? They were way too expensive. Now I just got one for free. Of course nobody's using scanners or receivers anymore, but it is just really one of those hard to get, very expensive, super, super sexy products from like when I was a kid. And yeah, I never could afford one, but this is just, I don't know, how old is this really? Let's have a look. No, there's no name, how old is this? We'll see when we get inside, but first let's try and play with it. I even got the manual. Look at that. And that is what you need, because the display here and the buttons, it looks like it could be easy, but it is far from the way that you think it is done. Everything here is just not like you think. So it's impossible to figure out how to use this without the manual. It took me half an hour just to figure out how to set the clock, but I was so stubborn, I wanted to see if I could figure it out. But it's, of course, super easy when you got the manual. Oh my god. And it doesn't really remember where you left. So if you want to go to manual, plug in a 100 point la 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 la. Okay, so this will be megahertz, right? But see, it goes to narrow FM. What? So wide, enter. And now you can... Yeah, we got music. I had to put on an external speaker because the internal is just absolutely rubbish. But a tiny little external speaker, and wow, nice sound, really? We got light in here. I would assume if you can imagine in the 80s, you're lying in your bed at night listening to police radio. So you want light in here and you want to be able to have a clock. Beep. And then it shows the time. And you can hear music at the same time. Or you can scan hundreds of banks of almost any most frequency, wide and narrow and AM and everything. It is really, really nice that way. So let's try manual, like 145.225, enter. So this is narrow FM. Oh, good luck. And then crank up the squelch, maybe a lot of more volume, like that, right? So if we take, a little handy here and say,
"Hala hala hoopa hoopa."
You see, it works. And if I go just 1, 2, so that this is a full channel up, right? See, nothing. So it is really selective and sensitive. It's working. Wow, cool. So. What is inside? Let's do the teardown. This is funny, see? I was so busy unscrewing the rubber feet, but no! They got screws right next to the rubber feet. It's in 99% of all other units, you're hiding the screws behind rubber feet, or stickers or little plastic thingies. Nobody needs to see the screws so you can open stuff. No, 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 not here. You can access the screws. Easy, easy. So easy that it is too easy. Wow, did you expect this? Oh, by the way, I forgot to show the antenna jack, and there's a minus 10 dB. So if you're listening to really, really powerful stations, that's maybe overdriving or something. But did you expect all that? So we got even another case down there, and then another PCB, a piece of metal, and then this board full of all sorts of funky stuff. All the receivers, all the crystals, and... Okay, this is the external speaker. What funny thin cables like that. And okay, so this is, what is that connector doing? Ah, this is of course for AM, right? So there's also an AM receiver up here, maybe. Main unit SS. Oh, let's take off the bottom plate and then or the bottom casing. Oh, where is it? Actually, yeah. What is that doing? That's funny. And this is the bottom part. Just disconnected the speaker cable so we could easily poke around in here. I love the little fuse holder. So I guess there will be a band pass filter or low pass, high pass. But this is the antenna input for the other receiver, and it is also packed inside also some metal cans and everything. Right, so that means antenna goes in here first, and then there's probably a filter down here, maybe some of those small parts here, the first little thing, and then out again to the next receiver. So this is probably that. And we got a little microcontroller here, Nick Microbrainy, doing all the fancy pansy stuff. So this is where the software is, and that capacitor here is 1 farad, 5.5 volt. And what do you know, that capacitor is what runs the clock, and it's just running for an entire week. Look what it says here in the manual. Ooh, a specially made capacitor. How about that? So there's no need for batteries like other scanners. That is so cool. And this one will cover 25 to 550 megahertz. That is crazy. Yeah. But that is basically what is in here. Can't really go into all these that are soldered together. But it is really, really nice for its age. Oh, look at that one. Boing, boing. Why didn't they care to solder this in here? Why those funky legs? What have we got here? Two diodes doing some good stuff? Okay, this will be the area where the speaker is. And the display unit. And the keyboard goes into the display. So it's probably scanned and everything on the display. And there will be an interface, yeah, that'll be the display interface that goes to also. Oh, look, there's another neck here. Nah, this is just analog stuff. Analog switch for audio. Select the one receiver and not the other one and something like that. Probably the different bands of audio and receiver chips, blah, 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 boring. Yeah, but that is what we got in one of them super sexy scanners from the good old times. Didn't we find any date? Oh, 84, 83, 84 on that one. 85. So that means the oldest chip, or the newest chip. No, this is the number of it. So it's still 84, right? 83, 84. So this thing is probably from 84. Wow, 84. That is exactly when I was a little snotty boy. With boogers in my face.